Hello learners, our today's session is on monetary policy of India, and in this session we are covering the meaning of monetary policy, objectives of monetary policy, and the quantitative tools of monetary policy. The word monetary means something related to money. So monetary policy means a policy related to money. So today we are discussing the money related policy of the country. And the formal meaning of monetary policy is it's a macroeconomic policy tool used by the monetary authorities of a country to influence interest rate, inflation, and credit availability through the changes in money supply available in the economy. All over the world, the monetary policy of the countries, they are announced by their central bank, and in India, it is announced by the Reserve Bank of India, which is the central bank of the country. Monetary Policy Department of the Reserve Bank of India assists the Monetary Policy Committee. Monetary Policy Committee is a committee of 6 members, wherein the governor of the RBI is the chairperson of the committee. Deputy governor is the in charge of monetary policy, and there are 4 other members of the committee. So the Monetary Policy Department of the RBI, it assists the Monetary Policy Committee in formulating the monetary policy of the country. Monetary Policy Committee, they determines the policy interest rate to target the inflation in the country. And this monetary policy, this is also known as credit policy because the stress is primarily on the direct credit. So the RBI, they formulate and execute the monetary policy with some objectives. And the main objective of monetary policy is to maintain the price stability. Price stability means to control over inflation. And inflation in the economy can be controlled through the money supply. Monetary policy, they regulate the money supply to maintain the price stability. Next objective of monetary policy is the generation of employment. Expansionary monetary policy generally increases the employment because higher money supply stimulates business activities that lead to the expansion of the job market. Expansionary monetary policy means when the RBI expand the funds or release more money in the economy. When there is more supply of money in the economy, in the market, then the businessmen, entrepreneurs, they will get the money at the cheap rate of interest, and they use that money for further setup of more units, more manufacturing units. They will diversify their business, they will plant more projects, and they will come up with new projects, and for that they required manpower, and ultimately there will be increase in the employment in the economy. Next is the interest rate stability. Interest rate stability is very much required in the economy. If there is a fluctuation in the interest rate, then it creates the uncertainty in the economy. And it makes also more and more difficult for the consumer and customers to plan for their future. So fluctuation in interest rate affect the consumer willingness to buy durable goods such as houses, motor cars, refrigerators, washing machine, or even personal computers, etc. So RBI, through the monetary policy, brings the interest rate stability by consistent policy rate. Next objective of monetary policy is controlling the imports and export. By helping industries to secure a loan at a reduced rate of interest, monetary policy helps export-oriented units to substitute imports and increase export. Thus, in turn, it helps to improve the condition of balance of payment. Next is the helping with the development of infrastructure. Monetary policy also allows concessional fundings for the development of infrastructure within the country. Allocating more credit for priority sectors. RBI, through the monetary policy, helps the priority sector by providing them fund. And the priority sectors, they includes the industries, agriculture, small scale industries, agriculture, undeveloped section of society, etc. So RBI, through their monetary policy, they help these priority sectors by providing them fund at a cheaper rate of interest. And also RBI, along with NABARD, is focusing on microfinance through the promotion of self-help groups and other institutions. So these are the objectives of the monetary policy. So next is the quantitative tools of monetary policy. RBI uses its monetary policy to control the inflationary and deflationary situations in the economy by using the tools of monetary controls. And these tools are, first one is cash reserve ratio. The cash reserve ratio is the ratio of the total deposits of bank, that is NDTL, which is kept with the RBI in the form of cash. NDTL is demand deposits and time, demand liabilities and time liabilities. These are the total deposits with the bank, and minus deposits of bank with other banks. So these are the bank's net deposit time liabilities. So the banks, they maintain a certain percentage of this net deposit time liabilities in the form of cash with the RBI. And that percentage is called the CRR, cash reserve ratio. At present, cash reserve ratio is 3%. So this picture explains how the CRR works. Suppose if there are rupees 1,000 deposit with the bank and the CRR is 4%, it means 4% of 1,000 is rupees 40. It means rupees 40 have to keep with the RBI, and rest 960s are available. 960 is available with the bank for the further loan. And suppose if the CRR ratio is decreased, it comes to 3%, then the CRR with the bank, CRR with the RBI will be rupees 30, and 970 rupees are available for the bank with the banks for the loan purposes. So according to the situation in the economy, RBI increase or decrease the CRR, cash reserve ratio of the banks. Suppose if there is inflation in the economy, inflation means when the prices of goods are high in the market. So in that case, the RBI, they will increase the CRR ratio. By increasing the CRR ratio, there will be less money with the banks. Less money with the banks for the further loan purposes. It will reduce the money supply in the economy. People will have less money with them. Then the demand of goods will also decrease. If the demand of goods will decrease, it will decrease the prices of product also. So this is how the RBI, they control the situations in the economy. So in deflationary situation, the RBI will do the vice versa. They will decrease the CRR ratio. In 1999-2000, RBI started to pay interest on the CRR money to the scheduled bank. The money which is kept with the RBI, by the banks, RBI started giving interest on that money. But in 2007, RBI discontinued this interest payment facilities. Next tool available with the RBI is the SLR, that is statutory liquidity ratio. Statutory liquidity ratio is the ratio of the total deposits, that is NDTL, of a bank that a commercial bank has to maintain in the form of cash, gold, and other RBI approved securities and government securities. So in case of CRR, it is the cash which has to be keep aside, which has to be kept aside by the commercial bank. And in case of SLR, along with the cash, they have to keep aside the gold and other RBI approved securities and government securities with the RBI. At present, the SLR is 18%. The both CRR and SLR have been the traditional tools of the central bank monetary policy to control credit growth, flow of liquidity, and inflation in the economy. So RBI to use these tools to control the situation, to control the economic situation of the country. Next tool is the bank rate. So bank rate is the interest rate which the RBI charges from its client on the long-term lending is known as the bank rate. Clients includes the government of India, state governments, banks, financial institutions, cooperative banks, and non-banking financial corporations like UTI, LIC, etc. So when these financial institutions, they charge, they borrow funds from the RBI, they don't require any collaterals. Means they don't have to pledge any securities with the RBI for their borrowings. And this bank rate that has a direct impact on the further lending activities of these financial institutions. Because if the RBI increase the bank rate, that will have a direct impact on the lending activities of these financial institutions. If the bank rate will increase, the commercial banks and other financial institutions, they will also increase the interest rate, which they charge from their clients. So to control the inflation, also RBI increased the bank rate. And at present, bank rate is 4.25%. Next is the repo rate. So repo rate is the interest rate charged by the RBI from their clients on their short-term borrowings against collaterals. So in case of this, for the short-term borrowings, RBI, the clients, the financial institution or the banks, they have to keep some collaterals with the bank. They have to keep some securities with the bank to get these short-term loans from the RBI. And the rate of interest at which the RBI provide loan, these short-term loan to these financial institution is called the repo rate. If RBI wants to make it more expensive for the clients to borrow money, it increases the repo rate. Similarly, if it wants to make it cheaper for the client to borrow money, it reduces the repo rate. Next is the reverse repo rate. Now at present, the repo rate is 4%. Next is the reverse repo rate. That is 3.35%. And learner, the reverse repo rate will always be less than repo rate. So reverse repo rate is what? It is the interest rate of interest or interest the RBI pay to its client who offers short-term loan to it against the collaterals. And at present, the rate is 3.35%. And in case of reverse repo rate, it's the RBI who pay interest to its client, to these financial institutions. And RBI keep the government security as a collateral with these institutions also to get these short-term loan. The reverse repo rate signifies the rate at which the central bank absorbs liquidity from the bank, while the repo signifies the rate at which liquidity is injected in the market. So we have talked about these collaterals, these securities which the financial institutions, they keep with the RBI to get the loan. So the LR quotas secure. So SLR quota securities, they cannot be used by the financial institutions or the commercial bank to get the short-term loan from the RBI. They can't use these SLR securities to get the loan from the RBI. So next tool available with the RBI is the marginal standing facility. It's a facility under which the RBI lends funds overnight to the scheduled commercial banks against government securities. This provides the safety valve against the unanticipated liquidity shocks to the banking system. So in case there is an emergency needs of funds by the commercial banks and they don't have the deposit with them to meet that emergency situation. So at that situation, they approached RBI and get these overnight facilities. This is called the marginal standing facility. And RBI charge interest rate for this facility. This marginal standing facility rate is 1% more than the repo rate. So whatever will be the repo rate this MSF rate will be 1% more than that repo rate. So next is the difference between the repo and marginal standing facility. Under the repo, clients need to borrow minimum of rupees 5 crore or more than that. And in case of marginal standing facilities, the banks, commercial banks, the minimum requirement of commercial bank must be 1 crore or more than this. RBI clients includes are all RBI clients like banks, union government, state government, and non-banking financial institutions. They are eligible for the repo purposes. And in case of only the commercial bank get this marginal standing facility provided by the RBI. Banks, they cannot use their SLR quota securities for as a collateral. But in case of MSF, the SLR quota securities can use by the commercial banks to borrow. And they can only use 0.75% of the SLR securities to borrow funds. So this is the difference between the repo and marginal standing facility. Next tool is the open market operations. This includes both purchase and sales of government securities by RBI for injection and absorption of liquidity respectively. So if the RBI, they want to contract the flow of credit, it means if the RBI want to reduce the money supply in the economy, they start selling government securities. And to increase the flow of credit or to increase the money supply in the economy, RBI start purchasing the government security from the market. So this is how the open market operation works. So this is so these are the tools. These are the quantitative tools available with the RBI to control the inflation or deflation in the economy. So next, have a quick recap what we have read. So the quantitative tools available are these SCRR, SLR, open market operations, bank rate, and repo rate. Then we have two situations. In one, there is a inflation in the market, and another is a deflation in the market. If the RBI want to fight with the inflation, in that case, they will increase the CRR and SLR rate. So to fight with the inflation, RBI will increase CRR and SLR ratios. And to fight with deflation, they will decrease the CRR and SLR. And open market operation securities, in case of inflation, in case to fight with inflation, the RBI will start selling their securities in the open market. And in case of deflation situation, the RBI will buy the securities from the open market. And in case of inflation, the RBI, to fight with the inflation, RBI will increase bank rate and repo rate, and vice versa in case of deflation situations. So learners, this is all about the monetary policy of the country and how RBI use the quantitative tools to control the situations, to control the inflation situation and deflation situation in the market. So that's all about this session. Thank you.